Hey, I'm Rasmussen and I'm what people call a creative person. I'm currently trying to build a career and find my inner voice. Some days it's really fun and other days not so fun. But it's all a journey and I'm here to share it with you.
Hello to all you unique and amazing blooming souls out there. In this video, we are going to do something I loved doing as a child, which was being crafty and especially making beautiful, very glittery greeting cards. We are not going to go as crazy with glitter as I did as a child. Actually, I am avoiding glitter a lot in this video simply because I am too lazy to clean up after the mess it always leaves. But anyway, I am still going to create some greeting cards that I am so happy to have in my life right now, and I'm so excited to give it to people that I care about. But we will, as always, do it in a slow, calm way, simply because life is already too chaotic. So all we need is some moments in our life where we can relax a bit, and that I will give you in this video. So let's just take a deep breath and start this video.
Okay, so it's now a Saturday evening. The sun is slowly setting behind you and I'm just ready for a new project. And for this evening and maybe the next couple of days, I really want to try and make some greeting cards. And it's not going to be with my own cute design, again, because of the printer situation that I'm still taking a break of dealing with, because, you know, just a human. On my table, there's currently a lot of different types of papers and tools and glitters and all of those amazing things that can help me create some amazing greeting cards. And the idea behind this is the situation where you need to go to some sort of party and then you have this present but you don't have a greeting card and you're like, oh, what are we gonna do? And you know, as the creative person that I am, I really like to make a cool greeting card that I have made, but I don't always have the time to actually create it when a party situation arrives. So I thought maybe I can use this evening to collect a lot of cool greeting cards that I can then have in stock to whenever a party situation arrives. Even though I am making these greeting cards for other people, I am still going to make them so I like them. Because, yeah, who cares? I mean, even though it's nice to have a pretty greeting card, I also do know and respect that people are like, oh, so nice, and then out in the trash. That's fair. I'm not blaming them. But in some way, that also just gives me the freedom to create greeting cards that I love. So I just think it's time to start doing that. So I don't have to stay up until too late.
Okay, so the first greeting card I'm going to attempt is this cutie. It seems simple and I have just collected what I think I need for this specific design and then just the type of washi tapes that I think look beautiful. So let's just go ahead and see if this is actually as easy as it looks.
Okay, almost 2 hours later, and here is what I have. They are very cute. I made some individual designs so they can kind of have their own personalities. They were simple to make, but I think my perfectionism was being a bit loud, so that's why it took a bit longer. And at the same time, if you think, like, I have made 5 cards now, and I'm not going to write anything because, again, want to let it be open to whatever purpose it might make sense to use it for. But very, very happy so far. Now I'm a bit concerned if I will manage to do or finish anything else this evening. But let's go and have a look at what my next card should look like. Okay, so here we have inspiration picture number 2 for the next greeting card. And here are the colors I have chosen to work with. And I also did a quick color swatching just to see what color I should use for the leaves, which is like the best match. And I also took out my new tool because right now I need to fold some paper, so this is going to be a great help with that. So let's just get started before it gets too late in the evening. Okay, greeting card number 2 is hereby done, and I think it looks very cute and very fresh. Again, not putting or adding any text, so it can all be up to whatever situation I think could be a great fit for this card. It's 11 p.m. now and I'm getting pretty tired, but I just have one last simple design I want to try out at least for today. And then tomorrow I will try and challenge myself even more with some more complex designs. Here is the inspiration info for the last symbol design for today. And here are the elements I think I'm going to use for this project. And here we have the final result. So cute. And it's kind of interesting because I went from 2 hours to 1 hour to half an hour. So I'm definitely getting faster understanding this process. I'm pretty proud. I am actually very happy with the results and I'm excited
to challenge myself even more tomorrow, where I have more time to play with, hopefully. But now it's time to go to bed. So I will see you all tomorrow.
Okay, it's another day. The sky is blue, the sun is shining, and it's only boosting me to see how far we can come today. So let's get started.
Okay, so here we have the first inspiration for today. It's in the middle category of complication, I would say. I'm not going to completely duplicate it. This is just inspiration. And here are the elements I think I will need for this. And I'm actually going to try and make two different versions. I also have this lovely book with different patterns, which I thought would be perfect to make these areas simply because I'm not in the mood to draw right now. Okay, let's get started. Here we have the two designs. This is just a simple page, so I will have to write everything on the back like this. And then this one is a flip one, so you can still open it. And I think they turned out so pretty. I really like this. The lines was a bit more wonky than my perfectionism would like, but at the same time, it just adds a personal touch and style that I really like about these cards. Okay, moving on to the next one. Okay, stepping up the complexibility, I will try to attempt to make this because I think it's stunning. So I just quickly need to get the tools to be able to carve this. Voila, and I also just went ahead and cut the different pieces. I'm a bit unsure if this is a bit too small. In that case, that it's going to be even more challenging to make this, but I'm going to attempt anyway. But I think first I need to sketch it out just to help myself a little. Truth, it is rough. I'm just not the type who has like the patience with thick paper and make sure it looks neat and all that. Even so, I think it looks stunning, and now it's time to see if I can actually fold it up. Oh my god, I think it's working. Oh, look at that. And then we just need to check the other. Oh my gosh, I mean, my hands are in pain now because of this, but I think it was worth it. Look at that. Also, I realized if I can figure out the knife on my silhouette, it could cut all of this for me. So if I ever decide to do something like this again, even though, you know, it's really relaxing and it forces you to slow down, I would prefer if a machine could cut this for me so my body doesn't have to suffer from it. Okay, now I just need to make a background which is colorful and pretty, so we can pop this on top and hopefully have a beautiful green card. So here we have the final project, and I love the ColourPop. I was thinking about adding a color to the rest of the card, but I kind of felt like it's was stealing like this attention, so I decided to just like the inspiration, keep it all white, so we really have this ColourPop. Okay, let's see what I want to do after this fun project. Next up, I really want to try this, and here are the supplies that I'm going to use. Oh my, this greeting card is stunning. I love everything about it. I also decided to put the leaves above this section just to give it some dimension. And I think it's so much me. I love it so much. Anyway, I think I will only have time to do one more design. So let's just go and have a look at what that looks like. So the last thing I would like to try is a type of pop-up that I think I can figure out. So we have this super pretty butterfly thingy, and I think I have figured it out. So I have pre-made the white simple card, and then what I think I need to do is have this long piece of paper and then fold it. I have measured, so this will be one butterfly, and then, you know, you just need to make sure to fold it the right way so they end up looking like this. And hopefully this will be long enough to look pretty, and it will fold and all of that. But let's see. I think I just need to try and see if I'm right or wrong. So let's go do that. I'm not sure if you can see it, but I drew a little butterfly because the plan was to cut them all at once, but I don't think I can cut through this many, so yeah, let's see what I can come up to do instead. It actually worked, but this also means I have to do them all individually, and it's going to take a lot longer than I thought, but anyway, what we don't do to create something beautiful to look at. And the reveal. Ta-da! I did it! The only thing is, it will never close more than this. But maybe I can incorporate that if I choose to design the outside, which I will most likely do just for myself another time. But for now, let's just enjoy this little pop-up I managed to figure out for myself. Yeah. So happy. Let's just have a look at all the different greeting cards I managed to make in this vlog. So here we have all the many different greeting cards I managed to make. And I think they're all so beautiful in their own way. And I'm so excited to use this for presents, which I can hopefully also make super awesome when I get a job in the near future. Also, my desk definitely looks like a mess now, so I also will have to do some cleaning. Yay!
I really do hope you enjoyed this crafty project. I definitely got flashbacks from my childhood and I felt a lot of joy. So that's always amazing when I manage to find a project which is more joyful than frustrating. I definitely had like 1,000 ideas, 1,000 inspirations, so it was really hard to pick out some, so maybe I will do this again in the future. We will see what will happen in the next vlog. I'm not sure, but I have a lot of ideas. So I do hope to see you in my next vlog, and I, as always, hope that you will stay loving and caring for me. I need to eat because it's way over lunchtime. So gotta protect the body, you know, so I can keep making stuff. But as you all know, before I go out and have lunch, we need to end this vlog with a little dance party.